Well, hello, my friends. Welcome to a new episode of Breakfast with Sergio, as we're doing the special edition. And today I'm super excited because I'm here with Shailene Hora. We're going to talk about listening to the voices of nature as we are all homebound right now. Well, hi, Shai. Good to see you. How are you today?
I'm well. Thank you for having me today on this beautiful day. Awesome to be here.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for, you know, sharing your art and this idea of connecting with nature right now, particularly as we all kind of like are in this mode of being indoor and can't wait to go outside. But that's something that we can do today. You're going to help us out today, kind of experiencing perhaps nature in a brand new way or in a slow-mo, right? In a slow motion way, since we are kind of like slow down. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Shai, you are also an artist at the Joby Art Center. That's kind of where we have met before. So you are based here in Chicago. So tell me a little bit about, you know, how you've been adjusting to this whole lockdown.
I'm grateful. It seems like my little family has been adapting pretty well. We're enjoying our time together. But it is true, you know, during the day we find ourselves being tempted to be aggravated with each other, but also with ourselves. I mean, this morning I was working through some feelings of being aggravated with myself, that I'm not producing enough content, that I'm not in the studio as much as I thought I should be. And then listening to that in my head, being peaceful and calm, looking at my daffodils and saying, wait a minute. How about practicing kindness to myself? So then replaying the script, going back and saying, I'm doing the best with what I have here and trying to remain positive at the same time.
And I think that's a wonderful message for, you know, all of artists listening or watching this video right now, because yeah, we feel like, okay, now I got all this time. I got to be productive 24/7. And that's not really how it has to be, right? I love the idea of being grateful to yourself, kind of giving yourself permission to change your rhythm of life. And because this kind of gives us an opportunity to do so. We live in such a fast pace. And I'm speaking for myself, you know, I wake up in the morning like, I got things I got to go, get out of the house, go, and then come back later. And so, but now this has forced us, all of us, to kind of like, wait a minute, you know, time now has a different meaning.
Exactly. Yeah, it's a funny paradigm that's happening right now, because it's in a way I feel like time has sped up rapidly. So I'm home, I have like 10 hours during the day, and it seems like the time just goes by so fast. Before I know it, it's 7 p.m. and I'm like, where did that time go? What's going on? So, you know, finding value in the day and then doing meaningful things that actually add value to my day. Mm-hmm. And when I look at the things that add value to my day, it usually is not task mastering. It is a walk with my daughter. It's, you know, raking the yard, observing the woodpecker banging holes through the sycamore tree. And I'm just, you know, perplexed by the fact that he has a tool fashioned on his face, and he's drilling holes in the tree bark right now with a tool that he was freely given on his face. That's like, oh, that happened to me this morning. I mean, that was meaningful. And I actually was able to create some work downstairs from that experience, from a woodpecker. So anyways.
Amazing. And what we're going to do today, which is a super special kind of thing that we are doing in this episode with you, since your art is based on this connection to nature, you're going to take us on a walk. And can you explain a little bit about what's going to happen, what we're going to do?
Yes. So I'm going to take you on a walk, on a little excursion that I did a few days ago, out into nature. And this is a practice that I reflect on weekly and almost daily, that informs my work. I am a botanical artist. Behind me, you'll see one of my botanical boxes that highlight some of my collections from North America, so Canada and the United States. And then you'll also see a few bouquets next to me that I collected yesterday from one of my walks with my daughter. But my work primarily is about listening to the voice of nature. So from a very young age, I discovered that there's a teacher in the woods, I call it. Mm-hmm. And the teacher is the spirit of nature that speaks to us, to me, to you. And I believe that it's an extension of our higher power, God, universe, whatever you want to call it, something greater than us that has a reserve to give to us and to provide. And our main mission is basically to sit still and to receive. Mm-hmm. And so I take that practice to be able to receive. And one of the greatest ways I receive is creative content. Mm-hmm. Ideas for creative content, patience to continue to make my content. As you can see, the seeds that are sown in this botanical box, there's millions of threads that go through this box and millions of seeds. So for my practice, I need to have patience with the threads and the materials, patience to collect the seeds, to dry them, and so on and so forth. And I think in all realms of our life, we need this patience. And it's like comes from the wellspring, from the spirit that I believe that we can access through nature as an extension of our higher power, and so on. So this walk that I'll take you on is an example of how I basically traverse the landscape, like very slowly. And I have no plan, I have no greater goal other than to just go out into the landscape slowly. And I either sit or I kind of walk slowly. This video captures a little culmination of both, where I walk out into the landscape, I glean or harvest a few objects, and then I retreat closer to the camera in order to make a bit of a process-focused creation. Now, the process-focused creation, I use a few tools. And when I explore out into a landscape, I usually bring with me a few tools. The tools being a pair of scissors, a pair of tweezers, maybe some twine or some beautiful string, a box to hold the objects, and then sometimes a paintbrush, some watercolor, or some chalks. So a bit of pigment I'll bring along. So this video captures like the use of tools and a bit of the creative process with no goal in mind, no emphasis on the product, but emphasis on the process of receiving in the position of rest, in the position of sitting.
Wonderful. Well, let's do it. So I invite our friends, as you're watching this, don't be tempted to go away and because
exactly.
It's in slow motion, going in real time. I'm not going to speed up the video. Just stay with us. If you're listening to this through podcast, maybe close your eyes, sit down, and just enjoy the sounds of nature and the natural sounds of the process. So let's do it. Thank you. Well, my friends, we have now enjoyed beautiful sounds of nature walking along with Shai. Shai, thank you so much for this opportunity, for taking us on a journey with you, for kind of slowing our day down in a place that we can listen, we can meditate, we can also reconnect with nature. Even if you are in the middle of a chaotic city, you know, today with this video, you know, you let us, you allowed us to walk into nature as well. So thank you so much. What kind of friends, Shai, can they find you on social media and your website?
Instagram and Facebook, and it's just my name, Shailin Hora. S is in Sam, H-I-L-I-N, and then Hora, H-O-R-A. Excellent. And then my website also showcases like my ethos as an artist, you know, part of my practice, the evolution of my practice from like being a farmer all the way being to like an urban botanical artist. And that's found at shailinhora.com.
Fabulous. Well, thank you so much. You've been so kind. Thank you to all our friends. Please, if you want to connect, let Shai, how was that experience for you? Or if you have a different practice, again, to connect with nature, I'm sure Shai would love to hear from you. Just hit it up.
Yes, definitely.
Social media, let us know. And please share this episode with your friends. Have a great day.
Goodbye, Shai. Thank you.
Be safe. Bye.